Oh, you're fine. You just released a brand new album called Weird Kids.
I did. Well, yeah, kind of.
It was just about a month ago, maybe.
It was actually released in February, but we've been releasing singles recently, yeah. So it's confusing.
Oh, maybe.
We tricked everybody, though. We did. It was like, it's still new. Got it.
Can you tell me about the album and the current single you have out?
Well, the album is... There's like a bug on the carpet. I keep staring at it. I don't know what it is. Anyway, the album is it's very personal, and like we actually wrote it here, most of it here in LA, some of it at home in New York, and we just... I think we decided that we wanted to kind of not, like, limit ourselves, so like any idea got brought to the table. And I think after a while we just had so many ideas, and it was nice because we can kind of like, you know, chop them off as we go, and it was cool. Yeah. And right now our newest single is Manners, and we just put a music video up for it. And it's really interesting.
And you worked with John Feldman on this album. Yeah. What was it like working with him, and how did you go about deciding on him?
Well, we decided on working with him. We took phone calls from a bunch of different producers and stuff. And we were just like, we connected on the phone first. We were like, this is great. So we went in with him last August and just did one song. And we just loved it. And the way he goes about it and everything was just amazing. So what he likes to do is he likes to jam out the idea like acoustically and very like organically, and then just keep adding. And we used to just kind of, like, we would just go for it normally. And we never used to pick apart our songs that way. So it's really nice. And it was like, there was less room for error, like, once you're, you know, you started tracking things. So that was nice. And he really knew how to push my limits. Like, if there was something, like, whether it be vocally or just emotionally, like, why don't you say what you want to say then? And I'd be like, I don't know, because I don't want people to take it the wrong way. She's like, well, if you feel that way, then that's how, you know. He would talk me through things like that that I thought were really, like, important and, yeah, progressive for me.
Currently, you're out on the Glamour Kills tour with Newfound Glory,
yeah,
and Fireworks and Candy Hearts. How has it been so far?
Today's day two. They're sound checking right now. You can hear that. But no, it's been really good. Yesterday was the first day, and there's a lot of technical difficulties, but I can already say that it's gonna be amazing because everybody's friends on this tour. It actually was one of those tours, or so far, like yesterday I walked in, I know everyone. And normally it's kind of like awkward, like the first day of school, and you're just like, I don't know anybody, but it was great. It was just like, what's up? Like, it was so fun, so.
What are you looking forward to most on this tour?
I think I'm making new fans. Like, this is definitely a different demographic for us. Not like too different. Like, I don't think that we don't completely make sense on the bill or anything. But it is the people coming out to these shows are, the majority of them are hardcore Newfound Glory fans and have no idea who we are. And so it's very interesting to play Warped Tour, or play like these other shows that we've been playing, where like you're almost too confident, like, yeah, these people know us and they're gonna be singing along, whereas like, I know that this tour is gonna be like spotty, like there's gonna be this group over here that knows every single word and this group over here that's like kinda thinks they know it, and this person right here has no idea what they're doing and is like texting, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's fine. Like, the point is to reach new people, so I think that's gonna be our biggest benefit of this tour.
You've been touring for a few years now. What has been the best memory so far?
Oh, I don't know. The best tour memory? I don't know. I mean, they're all, like, I feel like my best memories are always like those big moments where like we got down to the show that was just like perfect to us. Like, cause you're always your worst critic. I definitely am. I'm always like, that sucked. Like, oh, that was awful. So something like that is definitely like a great moment. I feel like if all those moments were combined together, it'd be like, yeah.
Is there anything crazy that's happened on any of your tours, or like?
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. I always forget. I need to start writing these things down because we get asked that question. I'm like, And something will happen on tour, I'll be like, oh, I gotta write that down.
Maybe start a blog.
I know, like, it's gotta be, trying to think. Weird things happen to us a lot, but...
Is there any weird thing that you want to share that's happened?
I can't think of anything. For some reason, we get lost a lot. I always find, like, we're always, like, even if we're, like, everyone has their phone GPS on and the GPS, like, it's somehow we get lost. Actually, on the Best Thing video, even though this isn't tour-related, but we got stranded in the desert, and it was terrifying because we couldn't even call 911. There wasn't cell phone service. And we were out there with, like, the rented RV and, like, all the camera crew and everything, and both the RVs got stuck in the sand. And we were out there, and then it got cold, and we're just like, I'm gonna die here. We're gonna die here, and somebody's gonna find us and put this video out and be like, farewell. We're the crowd. But we made it out. We eventually, like, somebody walked out in the desert and, like, got cell phone service. It wasn't me.
Do you ever do any tour pranks with the bands that you're on tour with?
Yeah. One time in the UK, we were on tour with... I'm trying to think of what year. I don't remember. But it was All Time Low in the Somerset in the Main, I think, was all the bands. And I don't remember whose dressing room it was, but we... went in there and we flipped everything upside down. So the couch was upside down, the chairs were upside down, everybody's laptops and bags were, like, hung on the ceiling and stuff. Like, we just screwed up their entire room. And they walked in, and I think it was the Somerset, actually, I'm pretty sure. They walked in, they were just, like, really confused, like, because it just looked like someone robbed their dressing room while they were playing. I thought that was pretty funny. But yeah, I don't know. We've done some things.
I know it's really kind of still nowadays, it's still kind of difficult being a female in the industry. Do you want to, do you even?
Being, this question's always so touchy because there's also just as many people that want to dissect it in the wrong way. And so I always feel like I have to be careful, but I always want to be honest. And I think my point of view on that is that, you know, there's definitely, I can't deny that there's no issues, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I do think that it's becoming, you know, people are becoming more aware, and I think there's a lot more, like, you know, yeah, there's just a lot more publicity about it lately, especially now, and I think it's a great thing. It's a great thing for people to recognize and learn from and change, because...
Yeah,
And that's what's great. Like, a lot of people are... Not a lot of people, but I see some views where, you know, people tend to get, like upset about the topic or uncomfortable or, you know, like, just scared of it. And they're all just normal feelings, like, you know, trying to figure out how to say these things and express them and whether you know they're right or wrong. There's plenty of things that I've been through on tour that, like, I... have sadly thought it was just the way until I had to, like, after the fact, and been like, why didn't I say something, you know? So, you know, and also, you know, like, once, and I think the unfortunate thing, actually, one of the unfortunate things is, like, once your band becomes more familiar, it tends to happen a little less, and I think that's kind of sad, too. It's like, well, why didn't you treat me like that before? It's kind of weird. But it is, I think... Ultimately, I think it's becoming easier and just a very... I think just this generation is changing a lot for, like, females and
animals.
And there's that whole, like, he for she campaign that's out. You know, did you hear about that with Emma Watson? And it's just incredible. It's just about creating, like, you know, equal rights between both male and female. And just actually putting... You should Google or, you know, YouTube the video and her speech at the UN. It was just incredible and a perfect view on the topic. It was great. It's awesome.
Yeah, I think, like, nowadays it's starting to become more accepted, but, like, even 10 years ago it was still...
Oh, it was like, what are you doing? Yeah.
Like,
and that's the thing. I mean, there's still a lot of people that work in this industry that are from that time.
Yeah.
You know, and they don't get it. They're like, they just still think, like, you know, whether it be, like, a lot of times I run into some you know, situations with people that work at the venues and stuff, and they're just kind of like, you know, they'll honey you, or they'll like kind of just treat you a little bit like a minority in a sense of like, you know, you don't know what you're doing, and there's a very clear like stereotype that they have just stamped on you the second you walk in the door, and you're just like, what the fuck, dude? Like,
But I even noticed there's more female acts on the Warped Tour.
Yeah.
And Sheer Girl was really pushing for that too.
Yeah, and they always have been. I think Sheer Girl, and then
the stage. Sheer
Girl stage and all that is like just, I think that's a great thing, and it's drawn a lot of attention, and I know a lot of female bands have even, you know, gotten, you know, a lot of publicity out of that, and it's great. It's good recognition.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
So what would your dream tour be?
My dream tour would probably make no sense. It would be like us, obviously. I would probably want to be on it. Maybe not. Maybe I'd just go to it. It's no secret that I'm like a huge Pink fan. Like, it's like unhealthy. I just love her so much.
That would be a cool tour if you
played with her. Yeah, maybe also. Like, it would kind of work in a weird way.
Because she's kind of rock.
Yeah, she has those roots, I think, for sure. Even when she, like, does the really poppy stuff. And then I would throw Joe Cocker on there because he's a legend. And that doesn't make any sense. And,
I think
he's act in the middle. I don't know. Like, it'd be weird.
Well, I think, like, recently a lot of time.
And it's, like, this very weird thing where they'll put together a bill, and, like, on paper it makes no sense. Like, why are these bands touring together?
Yeah.
And then the crowd, like, you see this, like, this strange, like, a bunch of, like, demographics just come together, and it's just, like, really awesome. It's weird. But, yeah, I don't mind that so much.
Do you have anything you want to say to your fans?
Hi. Love you. Bye.
Thank you.
Thanks.